We were doing the topic electromagnetic induction. Electromagnetic induction. Okay. EMI. EMI, that's electromagnetic induction. I told last time, Faraday had discovered this. He had taken the magnet. In the magnetic field lines will come out like this. Infinite number of lines come out like this. This way. They are called, they come out from the negative side and goes to the south pole. From north pole they originate and they end up, they terminate at the south pole. These are called magnetic flux. Okay. We will take a coil. What we have to do, we have to pass through the coil. There is a circular coil here. Bring the change. How can we bring the change? We can bring the change by relative motion between the magnet and the coil. If you move the magnet closer, more and more will pass. Move it away, less and less will pass. But there is a change. We have to bother the change, whether increase or decrease, that we will not see. We have to see the changes in the magnetic flux passing through the coil. Whenever there is a change in the magnetic flux linked with the coil, passing through the coil, there is an induced EMF and induced current in the coil, and the phenomenon is called EMI. Okay. This theory is just a reverse of the theory that a current is producing magnetic field. If current can produce magnetic field, can magnetic field create current? The answer was yes, the reversible process. And this was shown by Faraday. By chance, just imagine the magnet and the coil both are moved in the same direction with the same velocity. Will there be current induced? Will there be current formed? The answer is no. When the magnet and the coil are moved, Hello?
Can you repeat again? I did not understand.
When the magnet and the coil are moved in the same direction with the same velocity like this, same velocity, will current be induced there in the coil? Will current be formed in the coil? The answer is no. Why no? Because there is no change in the magnetic flux passing through the coil. There has to be a change. Magnetic direction, but moving the coil, there is still a change. Either towards or away, there will be change in the flux. And there will be a current form in that case. But both of them, you are moving the same direction with the same speed, then there will be no current induced. And this phenomenon will not take place. This phenomenon takes place only when there is a change in the magnetic flux passing through the coil. Okay. Now, we have to learn there is a law called Lenz's law. L-E-N from Lenz's law. Lenz's law. It talks about the direction of the current. Direction of the induced current. Lenz's law. You can write down, it states, probably statement will not come, but please write it down. It states that the direction of induced current, states that the direction of induced current is such that it opposes the cause. It opposes. O-P-P-O-S-E. It opposes the cause. It opposes the cause. Which produces it? Which produces it? It opposes the cause. It opposes the cause.
Sir, can you repeat the word?
Opposes what?
No.
It opposes, it says that the direction of induced current is such that
Sir, your voice is cracking.
Your voice is cracking.
What can we do now? What can I do now?
So can you repeat?
You are pushing your microphone. You are sounding.
Opposes that, so we are not able to hear that. Opposes that.
Or maybe network issues.
It is said that the direction of induced current is such that it opposes the cause which produces it.
So some opposes the.
It opposes the cause, CAUSE cause which produces it.
Sir, so what did you say?
It opposes the cause.
Sir, can you write the word, sir? Opposes the word.
So you are saying the first two.
It opposes the cause which produces it. So it's when I don't. Lenz's law is the consequence of. Lenz's law is the consequence of law of conservation of energy. Lenz's law is a consequence of law of conservation of energy. Question again, make some. Lenz's law is bent down. Then they make it four options here. Law of conservation of mass, law of conservation of momentum. They will say law of conservation of energy. Then they will say principle of moment. The answer will be energy. Conservation of energy.
Is this chapter there in the first semester?
This chapter is not in the first semester, semester 2. But you have to do it now only because later on you will not get out. You have to complete the syllabus, entire syllabus, before first semester only you have to complete. Okay, now listen. Lenz's law says that the direction of induced current is such a way that it opposes the cause which produces it. So I'll show you that. Okay, if a magnet is moved in this direction, velocity is given in this direction like this. What direction current will be formed? I'll show you that. When the north pole, this which pole is coming towards, it is north pole, closer to this, the north pole is coming towards. This motion we must oppose. This motion is opposed by creating a pole in the quad, such that the motion is opposed. North, then this will create a north pole only here. Because north and north repulsion will take place. There will be a force acting like this. North and north repulsive force will be there. Then the motion is opposed by this one. And if the pole is north, what direction current will be formed? I think last time I told you, when current enters a circular quad in a clockwise direction, that will be north pole. And when it is not, when it is anti-clockwise, it will be north pole. So now the pole is there north, then the direction of current will be anti-clockwise.
So can you repeat again?
You must oppose the motion of the magnet.
The coil is
moving. Magnet, north pole is coming closer, north pole is coming, then this will be creating a north pole here. And the north pole means anti-clockwise direction current will be formed. On the other hand, when the magnet is moved away, they are showing the magnetic motion this side. That means the force must act, this must be opposed, the force must be acting in this direction. This pole will give the force in this direction, I am sure it's north. The force will attract the north. South will attract the north, then the force will act like this. And then the motion is opposed. When it is south, then the direction of current will be clockwise. Clockwise current will flow now here. Accordingly, we decide about the direction of current in the polarity of the coil. Now, other hand, let us keep the magnet at rest, but we are moving the coil like this. We are moving the coil this way. This time we are moving the coil, but keeping the magnet at rest. Now, what will happen? Again, motion must be opposed. This motion is opposed by giving a force like this. force must be acting like the opposite direction. How can you have the force acting in this direction? There must be a cross pole here. There must be a cross pole.
Sorry.
Cross pole will attract the pole. No, if it is cross pole, what direction the current will be? Clockwise. And if the coil is moving away, moved away, then what pole must be there? This motion must be opposed by having a force acting. That time, there will be north pole here, then the direction of current will be anti-clockwise. This way, anti-clockwise. Okay, now you just write down in short the rule. Okay, write down here. Towards motion. Write on this one. Towards motion. Create same pole. Write down. Create same pole. Write on this important point. Towards motion. Create same pole. And away motion. Write down away. Away motion. Create opposite pole. Opposite pole. Away motion creates opposite pole. In conclusion, we can add on, we can leave this slide instead of going the way I thought it is. But actual logic is that way, which I thought. In short, we can remember these two aspects, point one, another one. Towards motion will create same kind of pole in the coil, and away motion will create opposite kind of pole. Okay. You can just see, suppose we are having a magnet here and there is a coil, that is. Magnet direction of motion is that is given. Okay. Now, what pole will be, what direction current will be formed? Can you tell me what direction current is formed? What is the direction of current here?
Clockwise. It's anti clockwise.
What kind of motion is this? Towards or away motion? What motion?
Towards the.
Towards the same pole. Now we'll create north pole here. Towards motion, as we can do, towards motion, create same pole. Towards motion is creating same pole, north here. What action can we do? Anti clockwise. You say anti clockwise. Now, it is moved away this way. What the magnet is moved away. What will happen now? Which direction?
South.
This south pole means which direction current?
Clockwise.
South pole means clockwise direction. So that is how you will decide. Okay. Same way, if they change the polarity here and they are writing south here, they are writing north here. Tell me what direction current will flow now here. North. You see the motion of the magnet. Motion of the magnet is this way now.
North.
What pole?
North pole.
Yes. North pole, that is what direction current?
North pole, anti clockwise.
Yeah.
Anti-clockwise. Very good. Now you understood, no? How do we find the direction? Which law did I use to find the direction of current? What is the name of the law? Lenz's law. Opposite one. Direction of current is opposite to the cause. The cause of the current is this motion. Motion of this magnet. Or the change of the flux. That is the cause. Okay. Now, I give another one out here. Just see. Have a look. So this is south, this is north, and we are giving not a single coil, but a number of coils given like this, and there is a galvanometer here, galvanometer is written with G, this only detects current and gives the direction of current, okay, and we have written here A, and we have written here B, and they are showing the magnet motion like this, magnet motion is given like this. And now they are asking, what is the polarity of the end A? What is the polarity? That is, which pole is created at the end A? Tell me, what pole is created?
North.
North, because what kind of motion which is towards motion? No, I mean, is it this? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Towards motion created same kind of pole. What pole is created here? Not.
Not.
The other end will be force. Other end will be opposite kind of force as equilibrium. Other end will be force. What direction is the wind flow? Clockwise and anti-clock? What direction?
Anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise. This is anti-clockwise. This is anti-clockwise. This way. Clockwise will be that way. This is clockwise. This is anti-clockwise. Understood? Then I ask you, what is the direction of current in the circuit? This is anti-clockwise. And in this direction, the galvanometer will show this direction. The galvanometer pointer is like this. This is the pointer. Flow is coming this way, like this. What direction it will be pushed? It will be pushed in the direction of current. This galvanometer will be deflecting like this. This way it will move. Just imagine, this is something here. Some force is coming here, like this. Current is coming and pushing it this side. What direction does it move? This will move this side. No, if something comes here and pushes here this side. What direction does it move? Galvanometer is moving in this direction.
Clockwise.
Yes. But now suppose galvanometer position they have shown here like this. Where is the galvanometer shown? Like this. This is the galvanometer they are showing initially like this. Tell me what direction will it go? This flow is coming, flow is coming this way. Flow will push which side?
Not
upward or downward? Which side?
Anti-clockwise.
No, it is anti-clockwise. Yes, it is. It will be pushed upward, that is anti-clockwise. It depends upon the position of the galvanometer shown in the diagram which we have given in the exam. It depends on the position of the galvanometer. Don't mark up that it is clockwise and anti-clockwise. It will, deflection in the galvanometer will be in the direction of current, in the direction of current. That way you will take. By chance the galvanometer is kept here. Where is the galvanometer kept? What direction it will show deflection? Tell me what direction. The flow is coming this way.
Clockwise.
It will go down.
Clockwise.
Yes, accordingly you will mark. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
clear.
Sir.
Crystal clear.
Okay, clear. Thank you, thank you. If the magnet is moved the other side, this side, what will happen now? Tell me. If the magnet is moving this direction,
change in
what will be here? What will source here?
Opposite pole.
Opposite pole. Source will be here. The direction of current now will be clockwise in that
clockwise.
Now the direction of the current will be clockwise. And then the deflection in the galvanometer will take place in accordance with the direction of flow of current. Hope you have understood it.
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Yes,
if you are showing a coil like this, just have a look at it. You are showing a coil and like this. There is a magnet here. South and north is here, like this. Okay. The figure is given. And now they are asking the question. When this magnet is moved up, maybe it's moved up like this. What will happen in the galvanometer? You say galvanometer will give deflection. Name the phenomenon. The name of the phenomenon is electromagnetic induction. Current is generated here. Current is B. Can you guess what direction current will be? Clockwise and anti-clockwise, can you?
Clockwise.
Clockwise.
North pole, anti-clockwise.
You are seeing the away motion. You are seeing the away motion. No, away motion.
South pole.
Away motion is which kind of pole?
Clockwise.
North pole.
North pole.
Away motion will create the opposite kind of pole. The south pole is moving away. That is what pole will be created here? North.
This
side will be called north. If it is north pole, what direction current will be flowing? North pole is here. Direction of current will be clockwise or anti-clockwise?
Anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise current will come this way. Like this, no? Anti-clockwise. This is anti-clockwise current. Anti-clockwise will be running. And what is the direction of the galvanometer? What direction it will move? Upward or downward?
Upward.
Upward. Anti-clockwise or upward like this way, the cotton line, yes. You understood, I suppose now. So, in short, in summary, how do we decide about the direction of current and all? Current, towards motion, same kind of pole. Away motion, opposite kind of pole. That's why south pole is moving away, so north is created, that is anti-clockwise. Very simple to decide about it. Okay?
Yes, sir.
What's up?
Okay. Now I talked about a generator, okay, dynamo. Dynamo or a generator. In dynamo or generator, what happens? There will be a magnet. There will be a magnet. Usually it is an electromagnet. North pole will be here. South pole will be here. And we will have an armature coil, which is called turbine. In short, we call it turbine, like this. There will be an armature in A, B, C, D, like this. This one is called armature. Armature coil. Detail you don't have to do, okay. Detail part, detail is not in the, they have reduced it. The diagram will not be enough. Only little idea only you need to have. Little bit idea only you need to have about it. Okay. So we are having our dynamo or a generator here. North pole here, south pole here. Like this. So, I will give the name. Oh, ABCD is already given, the name is given. When we turn the armature coil, we have to move the armature coil. We have to move it with the help of an axle. There will be a rod or tap. This axle will be turning. So there will be a handle over here. With the help of handle, we turn it. Either clockwise or anti-clockwise, we turn. So this is armature here. We can turn this way or we can turn it this way. We have to give a force.
So even
if we are giving a force like this. We are giving two forces here, like one this side, one this side, so that it turns in clockwise direction. It turns in clockwise direction. This is turning in clockwise direction. We are turning the armature coil, which in short we call it turbine. In anti-clock direction, like this is here, so it turns like this way. So the flux passing through the coil will change, and there will be a current formed there in the coil. Induced EMF and current will be there in the coil.
I don't understand.
So we'll change. Hello?
Can you repeat again?
Okay. We are having a magnet and a coil, armature coil. This armature coil is turned, that means it will move with the help of this one. Action. We have to move it. What is a dynamo? By the way, do you know what is called dynamo or generator? Dynamo or generator? What is it?
Sir. Electricity converts
this
mechanical
is, energy. It is a device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Mechanical energy into electrical energy. Mechanical, first we have to give motion. We are giving motion to it. Why we have to give motion? Because we have to change the flux. If we don't change the flux, you know, previously I told when a magnet is at rest, current will not be formed. There must be a motion. That's why we are moving this armature coil. Magnet is fixed. Magnet is not moving, but the armature coil is turned. When the armature coil is turned, there will be current from there. I saw the direction of current. In what direction current will be formed? Okay. So for that, in case of armature coil, the rule will be Fleming's right on here. Fleming's right side rule, right.
So it was left hand
rule. Huh?
So it was left hand rule, no?
There was a left hand rule is not in motor. But in generator or in dynamo, the rule of finding the current, induced current direction is Fleming's right hand rule. Fleming's right hand rule for induced current. Induced current, to find the direction of induced current, to know the direction of current. Fleming left hand rule was at this. This Fleming left hand rule is used to find the direction of force. And Fleming right hand rule is used to find the direction of induced current, current direction. Right hand rule is used in dynamo or generator, and left hand rule is used in motor. Already we have given a force here. We have already given a force of turning. We are turning it. Okay. So when we turn it, same clockwise direction. I'll check now. Right hand will I use the same way. Here also the first three fingers of your right hand you have to use now. Split in the same manner. As I did in case of Fleming left hand rule. FBI. Same way you have to split the three fingers. Now direction of magnetic field we know to the cross here. And direction of my thumb is going where inward. The force is given inward here. What direction the current will be formed? Current will be formed in the direction, downward direction here. That is, the current is running in the circuit in which way? Like this is running. Current is running like this. In one direction. They may ask you, what is the direction of flow of current here? Direction of flow of current in which direction? Clockwise or anti-clockwise in the armature? What direction?
Anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise. And it is coming in the direction B to A or A to B. What direction does it come here? Check.
B to A.
A to A.
B, B to A. B to A. Yes. Now just think, what happens after half rotation is complete? Now this will be like AB will be here, CD will be here. Once the half rotation is completed here, like this half rotation, it has turned to half of the rotation. My whole direction is this. Now what direction does the current flow now? Just see, what direction does the current flow now? A to B or B to A? Yes.
Now A to
B. Same direction, anti-clockwise direction only, same direction.
No,
in the direction A to B or B to A? B direction, tell me.
A to B, B.
A to B, previously it was from B direction to B direction. Previously? What direction was it?
Anti-clockwise.
No, A to B or B to A? Tell me that.
So A to earlier it was
A to B.
B to A, now A to B.
Previously it was written A here, it was written B, now it was written C, it was written B. What direction current flows here? That's not B to A, no?
Yes, sir.
Now the end are changing. CD comes here and AB comes here. What is the direction of current? Direction is now changing anti-clockwise. Only what direction current will go in the side? A to B. In the same time, that is AB, once current is in the downward direction and the next time is in the upper direction. The direction of current is same or direction of current is reverse. What does that mean? In the same side, I'm talking about the same thing. Reverse or reverse. That's why we generate alternating current. One side is for half rotation, it will be in one direction, and for the second half, it will be in the reverse direction. Reverse direction. That's why we generate AC and the direction of the current or the voltage band graph will come like this. This way it will come. This is positive, this is reverse direction, negative. This is positive, this is reverse direction, negative. This way the graph will come. And such a voltage is called AC voltage, or such a current is called alternating current, AC. So, in a generator or in a dynamo, what kind of current do we produce?
So what will
produce? We produce AC, alternating current. Yeah.
So what will be there then? For the
what will be?
AC current.
Alternating current is called because we change the direction. After half rotation, the direction is changed, direction is reversed. Suppose one, it is going in the, this way, the next time it will go the other way, like this. It keeps reversing the direction. Such a current is called AC. Alternating current or AC we call it. Okay? Now the last part of this chapter.
So with what we will take out the direct current?
Direct current we get from cell and all, maximum of one cell positive, one cell negative. Direct current never becomes negative, in one direction it flows, but it flows in both directions. With the direction is reversed. Like this is a form of wave. And the last part of this chapter we have is difference between AC and DC. Difference between AC and DC. They have given in the book also AC with alternating current, DC with direct current. Direct. Direct is one direction. It does not reverse the direction, but it reverses the direction.
But in our house, direct current is like alternating current.
No, in house we are using AC. This one. Do we use battery at home? Cell.
So then,
we are using AC. We are using AC from the source, you know, power stations and all. In power electricity, the turbine is rotated. Generator, turbine is rotated at the entity AC. Let me tell you the advantages and disadvantages first.
Sir, at
AC, listen, AC is more economical, cost is less as compared to DC. AC is more economical, and AC can be changed, can be increased, can be decreased by voltage stabilizer, or can be increased or decreased by a device called transformer. When a DC value we cannot change, DC value is fixed directly. That way AC is more advantageous than DC. Where we want the location in both the directions, we have to go for AC. You know, washing machine, they use AC only. Because we want the, in both the directions, motion. AC is much cheaper than DC. One small battery will cost too much out there, you know, like nearly 15-20,000. And there is a limited load you can connect to that one. And but AC can connect any amount of load. AC is alternative, then it keeps changing in magnitude and direction, whereas DC does not change in direction. It slightly changes in magnitude, but it does not change in direction. AC can be increased by a transformer or voltage stabilizer, whereas DC cannot be changed. DC cannot be changed. Okay? Understood? So, they are given in the book AC-DC advantages and disadvantages. You can just go through it once. So, this chapter is done. So, after Puja holidays, we will be doing the next chapter, calorimetry. That is the second last chapter. Second last chapter we will do. And then the last chapter is, that is radioactivity. Then your syllabus will be over. Two more chapters to go. Okay? Now they have reduced the syllabus, that's why I will not be teaching about transformers. They have not mentioned transformers. And they have not mentioned about the diagram of AC generator or DC motor and all. The diagram is also not there. Only little idea only is mentioned there. And the difference between AC and DC, I told you. AC is alternating current changes in magnitude and direction, whereas DC does not change in direction. The source of AC or AC work on the principle of electromagnetic induction, whereas DC does not work on the principle of electromagnetic induction. In DC is generated when chemical energy is changed into electrical energy, or solar energy is changed into electrical energy, solar energy. That means in DC, the energy conversion is different. AC can be changed by using a transformer, whereas DC cannot be changed. Which one is more, advantageous? Which is better? Tell me, AC or DC?
AC.
Which is better? Huh?
AC.
AC, why?
Because it is more economical.
So, class started.
It is more economical and its value you can change by using a transformer. Is it polymers? Okay, thank you, then.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Thank you, everybody.
Enjoy the session.